Welcome to the Venterrobang Podcast.
Hey, Venterrobangers, want to keep track of the Venterrobang Podcast crew? Well, how about just listening to our show?
Whoa, calm down, Matt. If they're hearing this, they're listening to our show, Matt.
Oh, yeah, I guess you're right.
Yeah, we just need to point them to our website, which is venterrobang.com. That's VENTERROBANG.com, venterrobang.com.
Like Venterrobang Podcast, right?
That's pretty clever, yeah.
Okay. Tell them about winning a hat by Matt. Oh, wait, I just did.
Oh, yeah, you did.
You can win a hat by Matt. We also have a money map where we map out where our money has been.
And an Ubuntu app, which I don't think anybody in the world has ever used, but hey, that's cool. We got it, you know? How many other podcasts can say that, you know?
Not very many.
Not very many.
For good reason.
Yeah.
You can also listen to us on iTunes or on YouTube. We also have Twitter and Facebook. Our Twitter handle, is it a handle?
Username, whatever you want to call it.
Username.
Yeah.
At Venterrobang. And it's spelled the same way as Venterrobang.com. V-E-N.
That's pretty clever.
T-E-R-R-O-B-A-N-G. I can spell it too.
Cool. We also have a Facebook page, which is the same exact thing. You can go to www.facebook.com/Venterrobang podcast.
You can like us with a fox or in a box.
Okay.
Sorry.
I think they get the picture. There's other cool stuff there. There's actually a Skype and even our number. Why don't you tell them what our number is?
Our phone number is area code 707-412-8368, which is 707. I-1-2-Vent.
Clever.
Yeah, well,
very
we
clever.
Do what we can.
We do.
Oh, we also have a Flickr page and a Pinterest page. We even have
MySpace.
A MySpace page, for God's sake.
Yeah, and you can email us. You can actually call us, which obviously you can by the number he just gave you.
And you can email us at contact@venterrobang.com. That's venterrobang.com. Right. Are we done?
I think we're done.
Okay.
All right.
I think we're done. Just find our webpage, and you can find everything else from there.
Go to our webpage, and don't worry about Twitter and Facebook and stuff, because you can find it at the bottom of every page and stuff. So, are we done?
And I'm sorry. I probably shouldn't have yelled at them.
No, definitely. We'll work on that.
Okay. Well, welcome to the whatever episode this is. I don't remember. Is this 11 or 12?
12. We have so many.
Yeah, I think it's 12. Episode 12 of the Venterrobang Podcast. I'm Matt. I've got Jonathan on the line. At least I hope
hello.
I do.
Hello.
And we've got a guest here with me. We've got Carl Ray that's going to do sports for us. And we've got a new guest who's never been on the show before. And he's a buddy of mine from high school. And his name's Ryan Spilken. He's going to basically enlighten us on all the new sports going on. I'm just kidding.
I'm going to blow your mind with sports statistics. You just wait.
Ryan's like me. He doesn't give a crap about sports. I don't care either. So
I'm starting to not give a crap, and I have nothing to live for. My teams all suck.
Listen, man, just do some research about the old Mayan sports. That'll put some real gravitas behind.
You have
idea.
Roller derbies.
Yeah, we've got roller derby. That's I watch that.
Nobody's head gets chopped off.
Well, no,
derby.
Not enough.
Nobody's heart gets cut out.
No,
not yet.
We need some more of that in roller derby, I think, or even in just baseball.
Well, I think what we need is to have athletes lose their lives when they underperform instead of get paid millions of dollars.
it's kind of a gladiator theme, right?
Right.
Oh,
we can cut the scales down, too.
Oh, he missed that fly ball. Send the line out.
that would be worth watching.
Now,
it's
guys,
like the Hunger Games.
Before we get too far into this, is blue language acceptable?
Sure.
Okay, I just want to make sure I'm okay. So I should have asked that before we get going.
Oh yeah, we can censor that stuff right out. Don't worry about it, man.
Oh great.
Well, I tell you what, do we have a topic yet? Have we decided what we're going to talk about?
Do we ever really? I mean,
I got an idea for you boys: sports and beer.
That's our favorites.
Oh, hold on. Also, trucks.
Trucks. Yes. And dogs.
Monster trucks.
Oh, yes. The biggest of trucks.
Oh, I tell you what, while I try to figure out what we're doing, let's go to Carl and have him update us on the sports that we don't care about, but that our listeners might.
Do go on, Carl.
All right. First of all, the NHL has canceled the entire first month of the season.
Whoops.
Yep. Half the players are playing in other leagues. Nothing there. NBA's in preseason. They're still about 2 weeks away from their start of their season. College did start their practices just yesterday, so we're probably about 3 weeks away from college basketball. For soccer fans, World Cup qualifying is this week, so most of the leagues are off. So there wasn't much soccer, although as far as the big leagues.
As far as the big leagues.
Yeah.
Now, this is your sport, right, Matt?
Oh, yeah. Well, I say my sport. It's the only sport that I really watch.
Well, that's right? What I mean. I mean, it's your sport.
And I don't even watch, like, all of the sport. Like, I don't care about what's going on in the UEFA league. I don't care. I watch one team in one small little village in Mexico, and that's it.
Which they are 11th in the table of Mexico. But they do play today at 4. And they won their last game 3-1.
They're 11th?
They're 11th in the table.
The question I have about this is honestly, how do you even follow a Mexican village's goat-oriented soccer team?
The original Chivas. Chivas USA.
Yeah, they even have a USA brand team now, too.
And because they're close to that region, California, that's why they named them when they came in. And they started the MLS, they named a team Chivas USA.
Yeah. Well, the reason I watch them and how I watch them is on the internet. That's the only way I can watch them. And on the internet, I can pick up satellite channels. And there's actually a satellite channel called Goal TV, and it's nothing but soccer.
Is it just one guy going, goal, the whole time?
Yes,
that
pretty much.
Amazing.
That would be awesome, wouldn't it? There is one guy. What's great is that you can select, of course, it's in Mexican soccer. They have not all the games are on a major broadcasting channel, which for Mexico, the major broadcasting channels are going to be like Univision and Telemundo and some of those kind of bigger Hispanic channels. So
can I just say that I love Telemundo?
Telemundo is awesome, especially fantastic. Like the telenovelas, like the
so good.
Those things are awesome. And but this just as a side point, I finally got around to watching The House of My Father, which is the Will Ferrell movie, Casa de mi Padre, which is entirely in Spanish. And I know enough Spanish to enjoy the movie, and I had to rewind it a couple times when they were talking over each other to figure out what each guy was saying, but that movie, I died. I thought it was freaking hilarious. But
wait, this is an actual Will Ferrell movie in Spanish?
In Spanish. The whole thing is in Spanish. And it's called Casa de mi Padre.
A House of My Father.
Right.
Who has time to watch this?
Me. And it's from like 2 years ago, and I finally got around to watching it. And literally, it's all in Spanish. And he basically does it as kind of a mockery of the 70s Spanish film. So there's like a lot of really, really bad, like where they're in a truck driving and you can obviously tell that the background is a video, like on Super 8 type video, is the road going behind them. And every time they drive, it's the same stinking van that passes them on the freeway and stuff like that. It's hilarious.
Wow.
But they tried to make it look really, really campy on purpose, but it cracked me up. But so anyway, it's
like Black Dynamite for Spanish speakers.
Yes, yes. That's a great reference, by the way.
Man, I don't even like movies, and I'm sorry if we have derailed the sports section completely.
This is what ESPN Radio.
It happens all the time.
This is what we do. Okay. Yeah. Basically, we lost everybody there for a second, but Spilken was saying basically that he hated movies and that he
derailed the sport.
That he was apologizing for derailing sports, basically, and we lost everybody there.
Well, let me reiterate just how sorry I am for derailing the sports, and but I am not sorry for not caring for movies, and I have this whole thing where it's like, look, if there are explosions, ninjas, robots, ninja robots that make stuff explode, and possibly a car chase, I'm good with it. On the exception of like the Lord of the Rings movies. I love those too. But that's not a whole lot different except with wizards. So yeah. I'm so unusual. And I'm not claiming, you know, some sort of like special strangeness. But everybody loves movies, but I can't hack it, man.
I will have to say I watch more television now than I do movies.
Yeah, well, movies cost.
Well, but I mean, I even watch them, you know, off the internet, and I watch television just because
how do you get them off the internet, Matt?
Through legal channels such as Netflix. Yeah,
exactly. And
Netflix, yeah, Netflix.
Yeah, that's a good ad for Netflix, yeah.
The quality of films that they keep is
it's, you know, top-notch.
It's like the Criterion Collection without being called the Criterion Collection.
Yes. That's pretty much right.
Yeah.
But yeah, I just watch television too just because I don't have the patience for movies anymore. I can't sit through 2 hours of it. I just...
Yeah. Especially because most of the time it sucks.
Well, that's true. I mean, honestly, it's been a while since I've seen a really, really good movie that wasn't either a strict comedy or wasn't...
Batman.
Or wasn't like a movie that was, again, guns, crap blowing up, robots, God, ninjas,
Batman,
aliens,
yeah,
something like that.
Like, the Batman movies were great. The Christopher Nolan Batman movies.
Right.
Primarily because it had some gravitas, but it was still... I've said gravitas twice, haven't I? I can't do that anymore. Gotta drop that one. The Batman movies were great because they added some, you know, heft to the superhero thing. But the Avengers was great because it was like watching a comic book.
Right. And I didn't get into comic books until I was older, meaning like about, I don't know, 7 years ago.
Yeah.
Something like that. And then I got way into comic books and like had like a $300 a month comic book bill from Midtown Comics in New York. And then I got married and then that quickly got snipped from the budget. Yeah. My $300 comic book subscription went, you know, to a $0 comic book subscription. But lately I've been downloading them off the internet and reading them on my rooted Nook. And so I've kind of started to get back into comic books since the DC went to the New 52 thing.
Oh, interesting.
What in the world is the New 52 thing?
They rebooted all their titles.
Yeah, they basically said... You know, for some kid who's starting out right now, nobody wants to go back and read 5,000 comics of Superman all the way back to Action Comics number one.
I have one comment on that.
What, you would actually go back and read every comic
Action Comics? No, I have a comment about, have you heard about the reboot that they're going to do for Green Lantern?
The rebooting Green, the movie?
No, the comic book, their idea. He's going to be a gay character now.
Oh, yeah,
the Green Lantern is gay.
Yeah.
Who cares?
Yeah.
It's like, whatever. It's the same hackneyed, you know, like, you know. That doesn't really.
My thing is I don't really care whether the character is gay or straight or into animal sex. I don't really care. As long as the character can do something cool and I don't know. To me, I'm a DC fan. I like Superman. And all the other ones are kind of just like, in my opinion, kind of pull-offs of Superman. Meaning every other character can do one thing that Superman can do.
That's been the case since
The '30s. Yeah.
That's
for example, the original Green Lantern, you know what his like kryptonite was?
Yellow.
The color yellow. Are you freaking kidding me? The color yellow? You can do anything with your imagination. Create a freight train with your imagination with the stupid ring. But the color yellow
stops you dead.
I know. I always thought that was stupid.
Make it go around with a caution light and just stop it.
Exactly. All you need is like a yellow flashlight, and you've just basically eliminated the need for Green Lantern. And Aquaman, I thought was equally as stupid, just because. I mean, I understand that, like, what 70% of the planet is water. I get that, but. Who's committing crime out in the middle of nowhere in the ocean? I mean, who's...
Exxon?
Whale hunters?
Yeah, whale hunters, Exxon, BP.
Now that you ask.
But yeah, but as far as like street crime and stuff that goes in comic books, there's like...
That's what Atlantis is for.
Well, I guess that's true.
Street crime.
Yeah, that's true.
Mer-person crime. It's mer on mer violence.
Whoa.
I wonder if there's actually mer on mer action, as far as like if there's like an underwater pornography ring. Do you think that would be something that Aquaman would have to preside over? I would think that would be kind of his domain. I don't know.
I honestly just think it's inevitable. I mean, if you have a species with opposable thumbs, you're going to have kitty mags. It's just a matter of time.
A little fin on fin action?
Yeah.
I don't really know.
The fins on this one.
Aquaman.
She's got some gills.
I haven't seen scales like that since I was a kid.
Yeah. But listen. Look, Aquaman is like. When Aquaman comes up out of the ocean riding a big ass whale or something, you can't hate as hard.
That's true. That's pretty cool.
If Aquaman with a trident riding a great white shark, you're not going to be like, "Oh, he's a pussy." You're going to be like, "Holy shit, he's making that dude is riding a shark."
That's true. That's true. Well, of course, Batman had shark repellent.
Oh god, no.
At least not in the comic book. In the 60s really bad television show.
That is not applicable.
I guess that's right. That's another thing that I never really understood about Batman. He was kind of like just a normal guy. I mean, other than being extremely smart and having a buttload of money to buy all kinds of cool gadgets.
Dude, Batman's really wasn't parents like... were his parents were murdered in front of him. He's a psychopath.
I guess that's true.
He's the original version of Dexter.
Yeah, he's a sociopath. He's not he shouldn't be funny or lighthearted. The dude is nuts.
Yeah, well, and I guess he doesn't really come off funny. He always comes off fairly serious as far as... He always seems like he's all business.
Yeah.
You know, I don't remember reading any of the comics where Batman was trying to like invite the other guys out for drinks or anything like in the Justice League or anything like that, but
no, you're right.
Well, what would Aquaman drink though?
What would Aquaman drink?
Beer.
I guess the same thing as everybody else.
I guess.
His name is Man, so he drinks beer. That's a generalization.
He's not. Yeah,
it would be seaweed beer though.
Well, I guess. Yeah, fermented seaweed. Yeah.
Kelp shakes?
Kelp, yeah, there you go. Oh, what were we talking about?
Oh, our coral catila.
Yeah. Are you going to do the rest of sports?
Yeah, we do. Okay. Let's get into a little bit of college football. Jonathan mentioned on the last one about West Virginia's winning.
It's a nice transition, by the way, wasn't it?
West Virginia winning 70-63. 2 weeks later, West Virginia has moved up to number 5. They decided.
Yeah, they beat. Who did they beat? They beat Baylor, was it?
Yes. And Baylor dropped.
That scares me that you even know that.
His son watched the game with
him. Oh, okay.
Yeah, I mean, come on, man.
70
little father-son time. Don't knock it.
Yeah, that was 2 weeks ago. 70-63.
That's an intensely high score.
There was like, football game. If you watch the game, there was no defense on the field. I mean, the offense just went out and threw back and forth.
Well, we had several games that way this week in the top 25, and that's what I'm going to get to real quick.
Nice segue back to the sports box scores.
First of all, the first matchup we had was number 13 played number 15, Texas, in the Red River Shootout. Oklahoma being number 13, Texas being 15. Oklahoma wins it 63-21.
Good night.
63. I mean, that's a lot.
Okay,
that
another
seven touchdowns and nine extra points. That's insane.
Another big game. Number 12, Florida State played unranked Boston College and won 51-7.
51-7.
Another.
They missed some extra points.
Yeah,
I think they had a couple of safeties
or had a conversion. Yeah, safety.
Another close one was Ohio State, which ranked number 8th in the nation, scored 52, but only won by a field goal, as in-ranked Indiana managed 49 points.
Wow. Have these teams even heard of the term defense?
It doesn't sound like it.
Man. Well, it's like, hey, let's just pick 11 guys, put them out there. You know, we really don't care about it. We just want to score points.
Number 22, Texas A&M, beat number 23, Louisiana Tech, 59-57.
It's like basketball.
Man.
Sports.
Yeah, I know. At least that one was close.
The best game was number 3, South Carolina loss to number 9, LSU, 23-21. Mm. And that's probably it for the, as far as football. We do know that Chiefs lost today. The Rams lost today, so Missouri fans are all going, who can we root for now?
Yeah, it's kind of really, you know,
how's
kind
Green
of
Bay
a
doing?
Blah Sunday. It's kind of like no big deal, you know, like, oh, yeah, they lost. That's kind of what we expected.
Green Bay plays tonight.
How are they doing as far as in the...
They are Green Bay...
Are they 2-3?
I want to say... Well, maybe they play this afternoon. Let's see. Oh! Yeah, they're 2-3. They're playing 5-0 Houston at 7:20 tonight.
Okay,
guys. And this is an honest question, but those cheese hats that people wear to Green Bay games,
right?
Are those made of real cheese?
No,
because I'm
no.
in on that.
If they were made of real cheese, I would own them. I would have a freezer full of cheese hats.
But do you know why they wear them?
Do I know why they wear them?
Well, yeah,
they're cheese packers.
Right.
Yeah. Wisconsin cheese.
There's a lot of people that don't know. They're like, they'll go, why are they wearing cheese head? Yeah.
Well, isn't Wisconsin famous for its dairy products?
Yeah.
Well, the original owner
and
owned the packing place.
Yeah.
Oh.
How they got their name, Packers.
Mm-hmm.
I had no idea.
Yeah. It's a small town of like 30,000 to 40,000 size of Joplin, and they have an NFL team. It's a pretty unique place.
That is interesting. How do they even build a stadium for that? Like,
out of cheese?
No.
Yeah.
They are publicly owned, just like Kansas City is owned by Johnson County. They
really?
Sell stocks, and in fact, they are doing another expansion to Lambeau Field.
Really?
Right now. Mm-hmm. They're adding more seats above the luxury boxes.
That's cool.
See, to me, this is interesting. Not too interesting.
What I love. Yeah.
Okay. Well, okay.
Not interesting enough to keep talking about.
Yeah.
But interesting enough to comment on so that we can get past it.
All right, there's one more.
Go ahead.
Well, the last thing I'll cover, I did mention the Ice Bears last time.
Oh, yeah.
Park. They are going to be playing again at home. If you do like hockey and locally, they're going to be playing a doubleheader with their junior varsity and varsity against Iowa, 26th and 27th.
So what's that? Next weekend?
Yeah, I think it's Friday, Saturday. And tickets are $8, and the game starts 7 for the varsity. And if you want to stay for the JV that starts at 9:45, you're free. It's free. So it's like a double header. But, you know, if you're interested in hockey.
$8 ain't bad.
No, not. And, but the thing is, if you go that, that's double header, so you get to see two hockey games. Of course, it'd be late night. Then we'll finish off now with the MLB playoffs.
Yeah.
Anybody been following?
Holy cow. Yeah.
This is the. Go ahead.
Oh, I had a band practice. No, really. Bear with me here.
All right.
I had a band practice on Saturday when the Cardinals Nationals game was going on. And, you know, I would thought, because I'm not a sports guy, but the other two guys in the band are major Cardinals fans. So I was like, why are we practicing? You guys are going to stop every song and look at the score. I don't just watch the game. We can practice next week. But no, we had practice, and so we get done kind of early so they can keep watching the game. And, you know, third inning, and the Cards start to put some runs in on that pitcher walking everybody. And, man, one of the guys in the band was like, man, it's over, man. Cardinals, if they don't score more, it's over. It's freaking over. It's like, dude, it's going to be okay, man. he needed a hug. He was like, I just wonder, because I left shortly thereafter. It was, you know, my wife's birthday was yesterday, and this is Friday night, not Saturday. I'm sorry. So, and I, you know, I'm taking care of that business. Hey, y'all blowing up. So I leave, right? And then my whole like Facebook feed blows up with the Cardinals coming back. And I just wonder what was going on over at the house where my other two bandmates live.
Exactly.
Okay. Well, what I was going to say about the MLB play.
Well, that was what, Friday?
That was Friday night.
Yeah.
Friday night.
Well, I heard, I was out driving to put gas in the car and stuff, and heard like I was like in the fifth inning, top of the fifth, and it was like, I think it was like 5-1 or 6-1.
Well, I've scored the game because I am a diehard Card fan. I have my Bob Carpenter scorecard. So I've scored every playoff game the Cardinals have played so far.
What was it, like 6-1?
It was 6-0.
6-0 in the top of the fifth.
No. It was 6-0. And then in the fourth, they scored a run. Then in the fifth, they scored two. Then they scored one in the sixth.
Okay.
And then in the eighth, they scored one to make it 8. And then they scored 4 in the ninth.
Yeah, because they said I was listening and I was like, "Holy crap, man!" You know.
Well, this playoff,
because when I was listening, it was 6 and they just scored the 1, and it was 6-1, and they went into the top of the fifth, and that's when I got home, and so I didn't really listen to too much more. But then again, like you're saying, then I get my phone just starts blowing up with everybody and their brother talking about how
I was going to talk about the whole playoff.
They came back.
But what was interesting, each playoff series was interesting because this was the first time ever that all 5 playoffs went to the full 5 games. You had the Reds won the first 2 in San Francisco, and then San Francisco wins all 3 in Cincinnati.
Yeah, well, I guess that's right.
And then you had the Oakland series, where Oakland blew a 4-run lead in game 2, but then in game 4 scored 3 runs in the ninth to beat the Detroit to force game 5. And then you had the Yankee series, where you had the Yankees in game 4 decide to bench A-Rod for a pinch hitter, and that pinch hitter hits a home run in the ninth and the 11th to force game 5. So it was the first time.
So all playoffs went to 5 games.
Yeah, and it's the first time it's happened.
I suppose the Mayans were right.
The Cardinals' 6-run comeback. The comeback was the largest deficit ever for a playoff team in an elimination game in 106 years history of baseball. That was the largest comeback.
Wow!
So, and this is coming off the fact that they had probably what's considered the greatest World Series last year in Game 6.
Wow!
So. But the big news that Matt didn't know about, because he is a Yankee fan, if you didn't know that.
Yeah, I'm a Yankees fan.
Is that last night, the game went into extra innings. The Yankees tied it in the ninth, went to extra innings, but in the 12th inning, Jeter went for a ground ball, and after grabbing the ground ball, he threw himself to the ground, threw the ball away, and screamed in pain. And they found out this morning that he has broke his ankle and is out of the playoffs.
That's not good, because he's one of their
the captain.
Big players as far as, well, yeah, he's also the captain.
But... yeah, he's the captain. So
broke his ankle?
Yeah, he had bruised his ankle twice in the last month.
Two or three times, yeah.
Yeah, a bruised ankle, and they believe that that's the spot that it fractured. It was already bruised. Two broken. So the Yankees are playing right now. Last time I checked, there's no score in the fifth. The Yankees are down a game. They lost last night. And then the Cardinals play game one tonight against San Francisco. And that's the championship series. So that's all for the sports. Okay. So if you got any anything else you want to get off your mind, we're done with sports, so we can go into anything else now.
See,
hey, what about did you not talk soccer?
Oh, I am. Well, I did.
I guess my team is.
Well,
sucks,
I can update you on who's on head of the table. They haven't changed.
Because the
Bayern Munich is still ahead of the Bundesliga and undefeated at 7-0.
But all that's kind of on hold now because of
But I will talk about one game. They had the Clasico, which is in La Liga,
mm-hmm.
which was Barca against Real Madrid. The two best players in the world playing against each other. 2-2 draw. Messi scores 2. Ronaldo scores 2. And
those are two Spanish teams, basically.
Yes. Yeah. And Barca is still ahead at the top of the league with 6 wins, 1 draw. And then the only Chelsea won their last match. So Chelsea is still undefeated and at the top of the English Premier League. But like I said, they're in World Cup for the Nations. So basically those three took the week off until next week.
Because of the trials for the
right.
for the World Cup.
And I think the big one, if you're a U.S. fan, is I believe Chelsea plays Tottenham, which is what Rick Dempsey plays for now.
Yeah.
So if you want to see American play, that's on ESPN next Saturday morning.
Cool, cool, cool.
Yeah. So yeah, but that's pretty much for the sports.
I will have to say this.
Although we were talking your buddy, about... he went to school with you at Parkview, right?
Yes.
Okay. And of course Parkview having their best season ever,
football wise. Yeah.
Yeah. So I mean that's
American football or soccer?
American football.
Okay, thank you. I got twisted up.
Yeah, we in the translation there. Parkview soccer not doing so well this year. they rarely do well.
No,
but
soccer, when you come to soccer in Missouri, St. Louis.
Yeah,
that's where it starts.
Yeah, that's true.
Just like hockey.
What I have found is that soccer, how I got into soccer is being in Mexico during the...
We went through that the whole spill in episode 9. Episode 10, you told us the whole...
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The only thing you got out of the was
that's true.
Soccer.
I was on my honeymoon in Puerto Vallarta, and... It happened to be right during the
World Cup.
The World Cup, and
There
was nothing on television, not a commercial, nothing that didn't have to do with soccer. Everything was soccer, and like every other country on the planet except the United States, soccer is a huge deal. And so, I mean, it was like everything was just soccer, soccer, soccer. So it was the only thing that really there was to do.
Okay.
So.
Well, that's other sports. Let's see if we... did we talk about on the air or did we talk about off the air about the guy who jumped today?
I don't know.
That was off the air.
I don't think we were...
Okay. Yeah.
Well, what I want to mention is that the record on that before was in 1960. I found some photos of it, and that guy wasn't even in a capsule in 1960. He was an Air Force guy. They put him in a pressurized suit and a basket, and he went up 19 miles. And jumped out. The old record in 1960.
That's nuts.
Yeah. But that's not the... But the record for the highest altitude in a balloon was by two other Air Force guys. And they went up in a basket because they were talking about it as this guy's getting ready to jump from 23 miles.
This is the color commentary that's going on.
The guy kind of breaking in is like, two Air Force guys were in pressurized suits. Like in 1963, I think they said, or 62. And they went up to 102,000
feet.
Yeah. And then they came all the way back down in the balloon, landed in the Gulf of Mexico. But then when they picked him up, they like discarded.
They were eaten by sharks.
No, it's worse than that. They stayed Aquaman, in the basket. They stayed in the basket.
Right.
And so the helicopter just came and just hooked onto the basket. Well, one of them fell out. And because he was in French Isis, he drowned.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wouldn't it suck to survive all that just to drown?
But I'm thinking, what were they up there in a pressurized suit? The only thing I think of is that they, being early 60s, they must have been testing the...
For space.
The spacesuits. And that was the only one they could think of to generate the pressure to test the suits. But could you imagine being the Air Force guy going, okay, guys, you guys are good test pilots. We're going to use you as a...
We're going to flip a coin here. And
The monkeys will probably jump out. So, could you get in a basket and go 102,000 feet in the air in a balloon and come back down and test to see if these suits work?
The upside is the suit works. The downside is we lost Pete.
Yeah.
We lost the second best pilot in the entire Navy.
No, they would never send Chuck Yeager up there. I guess that's true.
Well, man, you know, look, in order to make an omelet, you got to break a couple eggs.
That is true. That is true.
You're not gonna like come up with some sort of miracle scientific cure without a few human experiments. I say let them go for the good of man. Let them go.
That's what I think we should do with prisoners. Dude. Like when they do the overcrowding, I think we should do
or test them for drugs.
Yeah, do drug testing on them. And also,
my sister would lose a lot of money if they did that.
Well, I guess that's true.
It makes a lot of extra money.
Now, Matt, that would be inhumane.
I don't care.
From the fact that they killed a whole family or something like that.
And I'm not talking about the guy who's in prison because he ran too many red lights. I mean, like, the guy who, like, you know,
tax evasion.
Murdered his entire village in Texas. That guy, that, you know what I mean? The guy who killed his whole village in Texas. I want that guy. And I say we, if we want to go fight in Afghanistan or whatever, we give the guy an M16, drop him out of a plane. If he lives,
French Foreign Legion was.
Yeah.
You had a choice. You could either go to jail or you could go serve for 2 years in the...
Well, I guess that's true.
Well, it is. The French Foreign Legion for years is that you could have, like, if you were sentenced, they would cut your sentence in half if you would serve in their Foreign Legion.
Huh. I guess that's probably a good idea.
Guys, we're solving so many problems right now.
Yeah. Then you'd have a bunch of Batman running around.
Yeah.
I guess, essentially. Yeah.
The Dirty Dozen.
I don't know if any of those folks are necessarily smart enough or cagey enough to, like, you know, escape those situations.
Probably not.
You know, they're definitely angry enough.
Exactly. Exactly.
And, you know, the every once in a while you got that one guy who gets falsely sentenced and, you know, whatever.
Rough go, you know.
Yeah. Tough. Sometimes.
He's in there for some kind of white collar crime. And...
Well, you might get better soldiers than some ones. They sign up thinking, oh, I don't have to fight. I don't have to go. I'll just be a reservist. And then they, like, come up with every excuse they can to get out of getting sent over.
Yeah.
Well, I guess that's true.
You got people who want to kill people.
I say let them go kill people.
But Matt, honestly, I think it's the white collar people who should have the experiments done on them.
I agree.
Like the people who, like the Enron folks.
Like Enron, what I was thinking.
Those guys deserve punishment. That what they did to a legion of people is so wrong. And anyway.
But I agree with you. Yeah, and not like testing lipstick and not testing deodorant.
And those two.
No, I mean, like, I think we should give them AIDS and then try to cure it. I think something like that.
I like it.
And not intravenously, not the easy way, the old prison way. I think they should get AIDS the old fashioned way.
The hard way, as it were.
The hard way. Whether we use other prisoners or rhesus monkeys from Africa, I don't care, but they need to get AIDS. And then once they have AIDS, then we can test all the AIDS vaccines on those people.
Well, yeah, but the new government thing, we have to take care of them.
Well,
the Obamacare, We don't,
Obamacare, yeah.
We don't be, if your insurance is too good, they'll tax you to pick over the ones who can't afford it.
Well, but I think that's part of the deal. I think if you're in prison, I mean, I guess the guys in Guantanamo Bay were getting.
Federal, federal care. They're getting everything paid for. Why not? We could actually sell rights to them to pharmaceutical companies to experiment
exactly.
on them.
Yeah, exactly.
Make money instead of spend it on these, you know, wastrels. Come on.
We just have to make sure that the trials don't overlap. Yeah, I mean, you know what I mean? You don't want them having cancer and AIDS and then not knowing which
of prisoners to separate them.
Which cure.
There's plenty of prisoners in California alone, I think, to keep them separate.
Well, I guess that's probably that's probably true.
I mean, this is some Batman level stuff right now.
Oh, man. Speaking of Batman, did you see the new Batman
yet? I haven't seen the new Batman yet. I feel bad for not seeing the new
Jonathan,
Batman
Jonathan, have you
yet,
seen
so
it yet?
I haven't seen the new one, no.
You guys.
Ryan, I've seen you.
Dark Knight Rising or something like that.
Yeah, it's great. Yeah,
no, I haven't seen it yet.
I see. Go ahead, Ryan.
It was good. But for a movie that I would watch, it was good. Yeah. It was, you know. Yeah.
That's true. Like,
I have seen it.
What'd you think?
I took my wife and me and my boy, which was the day after the shooting.
Oh,
And I didn't think about it, but my son the whole time was
There's
nervous.
There's another topic right there.
He was nervous. He's 13, and at the end of it, he didn't like it. He was kind of a little. And I think we didn't think about it, but I think in the back of the mind, he was looking around.
Waiting for some dude to bust in with a gun start popping off shots at people.
And the bad thing was is that during while we're in the movie,
somebody came
in with their gun strapped to their side, had their permit, and they called the cop.
Oh yeah, was that in Ozark?
Yeah, I was at the theater when that happened.
I remember hearing about that,
but we didn't hear about it until we got home. And of course, he heard it. So therefore, I kind of teased him. I'd do my Bane voice, like.
But that dude was just like, he didn't, I guess they didn't do anything wrong or whatever, but.
No, he had his permit.
Yeah. But they're like, in light of the situation, you might not bring that in.
And they said that he did go home, put it up, then come back.
Yeah.
Hope he didn't miss much of the movie.
That was back when, that was like buying a ticket for the next show. So that was when they were the first, you know, they run shows every like half hour.
It was a long show as it is.
Yeah, it was almost, it was over 3 hours.
Was it?
I think it was right at or just over 3 hours.
That's like Lord of the Rings long.
Mm-hmm.
That's going to have to be one of those that I just sit on my butt on my couch. Like, all right, pause that. I got to go take a leak, you know, or I need to get a drink. That's a long time to sit in a movie theater.
Either that or take two cups with you.
Hunger Games was 2.5 hours.
Give yourself a catheter.
Just bag it.
Yeah. Pack it out, you know.
Yeah. You could probably just pee on the floor. They probably wouldn't even notice. Okay.
So
when was the last time you were in a theater and the floor didn't like stick?
Well, that new one at Mozart, because it's only like 6 months old.
Well, I guess that's true. Well, not enough people have peed on that floor yet.
Not enough people have urinated on the
floor.
Let's just
hope and believe that it is pee.
I believe. Yes.
Since we were...
Or soda or something, you know. I mean, let's just...
Yeah.
Here, I got another topic, since, you know, you guys are comic book guys, right? And we were talking a little bit of movies, right?
I used to be, but go on.
Have you seen the previews for the new Superman? I have.
What?
There's a new Superman coming out.
It's going all the way back.
Oh, man. Dude.
I'm with you on this one, Ryan.
Thrilled.
It doesn't look that bad, though.
To be honest with you, Superman Returns was good.
Well, it has been, 25 years since they, you know, started that?
No. No, there was just a Superman movie
three or four years ago.
Yeah,
that's
right.
Superman Returns.
That was way better than people gave it credit for.
Yeah, I did like that movie.
And they're screwing up by rebooting that franchise. I think they should pick back up
where they, I mean, it had some fucking, It had some, it had some freaking history. It picked up where the Christopher Reeve movies left off. Well, mm-hmm.
Right.
Two, if you watch the director's cut of Superman 2, Superman Returns picks up where it should have.
And right there.
And it was great. And it just, they, you know, nobody cares anymore about, like, telling a cohesive story. They just want the cash grab.
Mm-hmm.
It's
going to
be,
yeah.
You're going to see another Batman movie in 3 years. And it's just lame.
It's going to be Robin.
Oh, no, it'll be Batman.
It'll be Batman.
Yeah, but
yeah.
It's Robin.
Christopher Nolan's not going to do it. It's going to be another reboot. You're going to learn. You're going to get Batman's backstory again.
Kind of like Amazing Spider-Man.
Yeah.
From a different perspective.
Yeah. See, that's Spider-Man. That's the part that I hate. It's when they is again, as far as the movies go, I would have to give a little bit of props to the Marvel people as far as not retelling the same stinking story 18 times in 20 years.
Except for Spider-Man.
Well, that's true.
They
I guess
change it.
But he's
they,
not. But the new Spider-Man movie is going to be in with the Avengers universe,
right?
So it's probably okay. But still, and at least with the new Spider-Man movie, and I haven't seen it, so I don't.
I haven't seen it yet either.
I know that that they're introducing the characters correctly. Like his first love interest was Gwen Stacy, not Mary Jane Parker.
Right.
So, you know, I could dig it. Whatever.
And in this one, it's like the original Amazing Spider-Man. He makes his web shooters. They're not
in his body.
In his body.
Yeah.
That's the way they did it.
Yeah. That's better. That is more good.
Yeah.
Plausible.
I saw it. I liked it. I didn't think I would, but I did like the new Spider-Man. Even though I thought they should have waited a little bit longer before trying to
bring it right out.
Yeah. And it's been like 4 years and ping.
But I will have to say, whenever they started bringing out, I mean, like, when I was a kid, I went to the theater to see Superman. I mean, like, the old original, you know, Superman series.
Got me in trouble once.
And I thought they were awesome.
Then you got me in trouble once, remember?
And then, how did I get you in trouble?
Remember the period where your parents wouldn't let you go to the movies? And we went before a youth group?
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, whatever you do, don't tell anybody. And then you told Danny. And it was like next day your mom's calling me. You cannot talk to Matt for a week.
Oh yeah, that's.
Oh, snap.
We've had this. Me and Jonathan have had this conversation before about weird religious crap. As far as like when I was growing up, it was like again, it was literally like against our religion to go to a movie theater because they thought that it was. I guess the rationale was the people who saw you coming out of a movie theater wouldn't know that you went there to see Bambi or the other Bambi.
Right.
Which I guess made sense back in 1932.
Well, no.
Yeah.
The best one was the missionary one time that came and told me that he was told by a church he wanted to show a film of where he was ministering. And they're like, you can't show the film. And he goes, what do you mean? He goes, if it's still in a picture, it's of the Lord. If it's moving, it's of the devil. And that's
fantastic.
Okay.
Wow.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
And
we wonder why people don't like Christian people, you know? I mean.
That was the 60s. I really think it was, he said.
That's ridiculous.
That's ridiculous.
You know, when you first came out, they
made. Well, and my thing was, because I remember having the argument with my pastor at the time, and I was like, well, my question is that we can't go to movie theaters because of what people might think. Yes, okay, but I can go to a video rental store where I can rent something that's 10 times worse than what I could see in any theater in town.
And you can honestly see more in the video store.
Just in the covers.
Right. and yet that was, we don't touch that. That was perfectly fine. No problem at all with that. Whatsoever, and I was like, it's bullcrap. I'm sorry. I gotta call BS on that doctrine.
Well,
and the thing about it with you, Matt, was you grew up with that stuff.
I
got saved or whatever in when I was 18 years old, and just from that time, just to shortly, you know, just a few years ago, man, you talk about the sole purpose or a lot of their purpose is to indoctrinate what you should and should not believe instead of going out and doing what the Bible says to do, you know, go out and reach the world.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, we can go on and on about that, but it's just, it's crazy how much we are, as you know, just as we teach our children, this is right, this is wrong. The church is doing that, and they're not doing it properly.
Right.
Now, not all of them. I mean, we can't scoop everything in, just like the whole Chiefs comment from, what's his name, Eric Winston. I wasn't talking about all the fans. I was just talking about the ones that, you know, cheered. It's the same thing. Not every church or every, you know, good thing is screwing things up. So, it's, well, I guess it's stereotyping. It's,
unfortunately, but, though, you have an overarching structure to this system. And it's the overall train of thought. So you might have some people who are doing good in the name of their church or whatever, but mm-hmm. why don't you just do good?
Exactly. Right.
You know,
exactly.
There's nothing that is wrong. I mean, I don't understand the logic of you have to have some sort of, and I'm fine with people believing things, right? But what I'm not fine with is people who insist that you have to have a belief in a higher being to be a decent human being.
Because there you go.
It's common sense.
Yeah.
Would I kill someone? Would I want to be killed? No. Would I steal? Because I don't want my stuff stolen. I like my stuff. Back up off my stuff.
Right.
So I'm not going to take somebody else's for that same reason. And I don't need to. I don't need to have somebody watching me to know that. In fact, if you have to have someone watching you to know those things, then you're not very trustworthy in my book.
Exactly.
It's just me.
No, I'm with you on that one. Yeah, I'm totally with you on that one too. That my whole thing with the whole organized religion anyway, I've got issues with that anyway.
Well, it's just like Einstein. A lot of people thought Einstein didn't believe in God, but he actually did. But he believed, he didn't believe that most religion was man's version of it,
which
he believed in. His whole scientific thing was this: you look at the universe, you can't look at the universe and say there wasn't a creator behind it, but he was looking for the, you know, the intelligence behind it. So he says,
whatever you want to call that,
he goes to me, if you know I am religious, if you call, I'm trying to find the intelligence behind the universe. And he did believe in God, but he just didn't believe anything that was man-made.
He didn't believe in the organized religion version of
right,
God.
Right, exactly.
He believed in the hierarchy, the organization, the fact that
of the
there is universe. A system that is out there that
somebody put together.
That is,
yeah, it's called math.
Yeah,
it's called math. I love it, and I love math. Statistics are a personal favorite of mine, but man, you do enough of that, and you start to see something.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's exactly right.
The perfect example is there's a story of NASA was having trouble trying to find how to get the very first Mars rover back in the 60s.
Yeah.
And their math was coming up short until one guy suggested a verse in the Bible where it talks about where God made the sun stand still for 3 days. And because they were stuck, they had been working for months, so they tried it. And from now on, they use that because that's the only way they get the figures to work to get
Mark. I'm gonna call bull on that.
Yeah, I've never heard that one.
That first of all, the sun doesn't. The sun moves in our quadrant of the galaxy, and we rotate around it. The sun, what?
Yeah, I know.
God made the sun for 3 days, not set. In other words, in a battle.
I remember the story.
Oh, man.
So that the opposing, basically, no. The opposing team could win, basically, so that...
That essentially, that's not science, my friends. Because, you know, in order for the sun not to set...
Basically, the Earth would have to stop. Right.
And therefore,
right.
Gravity would quit. And when gravity quits, everybody goes flying at a certain velocity.
Several thousand miles per hour.
Yeah. Hey, Jordan, you have to roll out.
Yeah, I got to get out of here. I got some commitments, but didn't know if I wanted to just duck out and let you guys continue on spieling. So,
right on, man.
You should give us a topic to feed off of while when you go.
Okay. Gay marriages or gay? No, listen, Gary. Gay couples, should they be allowed to adopt? Okay, go.
Why do you have to do some kind of controversial thing? Personally, my belief is sure.
Yeah.
Well, hey, this is a subject for you guys to discuss. I'm going to have to peel here. So.
Right, thanks dude. A lot. Thanks.
Hey, it's a real pleasure meeting you, Jordan. Jonathan.
It was a good chat. You guys knock them dead. All right.
Right on, man.
Later.
Well, yeah, why not? Love is love, right?
Honestly, I don't care. That, and I don't mean that in a bad way, but I literally mean that in the most apathetic way that I can. I don't care. In the same way that I don't care what my neighbor and his wife does. I don't care in the same way that I don't care what guys three houses down are doing in their living room at 3 a.m. next Tuesday. I just don't care. Again, in my belief system, whatever you want to call that, basically, I believe in a very basic religion, I guess, if you want to even call it religion. I think religion's kind of a bad word, but I would say that people are going to do what they want to do, and I think they're going to do what they want to do, whether anybody around them says or thinks that it's right or wrong or otherwise. And as long as it's not, in essence, hurting anybody else, and it's not hurting themselves, unless they want to be hurt, if that's their thing, whatever. But other than that, I don't know. I just don't care.
Well, so you know what I say to that, Matt?
What's that?
Praise the Lord and pass the ammunition.
That's right. My thing is that I think it depends, on the, you have a lot of kids out there. They're in the DS system.
Right.
Who are some of their, their parents, they need a home. I mean, so if there's not, and that's the best to have a loving home, then okay. But I think it's individual. It just depends on the situation. If there's
I don't want to give a kid to a couple of gay or lesbian serial killers in the same way that I wouldn't want to give them to.
Well, that's my point. I mean,
heterosexual serial killers.
Because there's some people that are in the system that are like that. A foster parent. There's some bad foster parents out there. So I mean,
right.
I mean. If you need people and they're going to give them a better home, I don't have a problem with
it. Yeah. The better the home a kid lives in, right. The better they're going to turn out for society. I'd rather have a kid living with, two,
just very, like you.
Yeah. You know what I'm just saying? Like,
yeah. Just as if those kids get to that point where you don't have the, a heterosexual, forcing them into like what they believe, when it comes to that sexual. That's my thing. As long as you don't want the heterosexuals to determine that you have to be heterosexual, same way. I think,
they're open. Well, right. And
that's why they should both be.
I just don't think that any homosexual parent would do that to a kid because they know how hard it is to be themselves.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not going to turn, they're not, they might force a kid to invest in a way they don't want to, but they're certainly not going to want to make them like pick a gender.
Well, and to me, that's no different than
normal parents.
Normal parents, and by normal is kind of a subjective word anyway, but
of course.
But as far as I don't know, I with stuff like that, when it really gets down to these things that are quote unquote hot button topics and hot button issues, most of the time I go back to what is the I currently reside in America, and as being someone who lives in America, I think that we should abide by the laws of America. Now, that said, I think that it should just be, as far as the Constitution, I don't think that the government should decide who, you know, as far as, like, what... I don't think that there should be a law saying that kids can only go with heterosexual parents or... You know what I mean? So this whole thing about it being...
Yeah, anyone, you know, who wants to push, anyone who wants to push morality laws is has an ulterior agenda. And I would not, in a heartbeat, like, I would argue that point in a for a long time. Because if you're pushing morality, you're pushing your worldview on somebody. You're not pushing, like, a logical and reasonable hierarchy on anyone. You're pushing your beliefs. I don't care, you know, like Maddow said about, you know, if you find if what somebody else does in their bedroom is icky to you, that's their right. You don't need to dictate that. So anyone who wants to dictate that also wants to manipulate some other things. That's evil.
Right.
That's where evil is. That's where it lives.
And I agree. I don't know. I just think it should be simple. I just think that we make things, everything, I think in life, we make things just harder than they should be.
Oh, yeah.
And that's, I think that the simple thing is the basic law of the land is do whatever you want to, as long as it doesn't hurt me and it doesn't hurt the guy next to you and it doesn't hurt yourself.
Yeah.
And that, you know what I mean? And that's kind of the deal, no matter what that is, whether that's owning guns, whether that's your sexual preference, whether that's your race, whether that's your religion, whatever that is.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Do whatever you want to do. You know what I mean? And as long as you kind of stay out of everybody else's business and they stay out of your business, then in theory, the world should keep going around and everybody should kind of be happy and...
Well, I'll tell you, man, it'll still go around. It's not going to stop.
It's not going to stop for 3 days.
It's not going to stop for 3 days. It's just going to roll. It's going to roll on. And if we, you know, we have two choices, and I think this is going to feed into something you're going to work on. We're going to go the Roddenberry way. We're going to go the Star Trek way and figure out that our differences are way less than our differences with, you know, another planet species. Or
right.
we're gonna like just wipe ourselves out, and then nature will start fresh. And here's the beautiful thing about that: let's say humanity wipes ourselves out. Humanity is gone. Eventually, life will come back around on this planet, right?
Right. In some form or fashion.
In some form or fashion, and if it ever becomes intelligent again, or resembles our version of intelligence, it will figure out math. It will figure out science. But all the mythological stories will be totally different.
Right.
So it's okay. You know, everything's going to be all right. World keeps on turning.
That's right.
Time keeps on slipping into the future.
Into the future. Well, all right. Well, I think we covered that. And we're at about our hour mark.
Oh, man.
So we'll save the rest of that for next time, man.
Hey. Thank you so much for having me.
Hey, thanks for coming on here. By the way, do you want to plug your musical interests, your band and all that?
You know, but I don't have much of a band anymore. I do play in a band called the Nova Heat, and you can look us up on Facebook. If you want, I made a full album with a band called the North Decade, and our album is available for free on Bandcamp, and you can just have it. It's, thenorthdecade.bandcamp.com. And if you look me up, Ryan Spilken, I'm on sound. I just put a little country waltz song up on SoundCloud. Just search for my name on SoundCloud. You'll find my...
Very, very cool. Well, what we'll do is if you can send me all those links, I'll put them on our podcast post with this podcast too.
You got them, man.
That way it'll make it easy for everybody to just click on it and go.
Hey, well, I hope we didn't get too heavy. I'm sorry.
it kind of turned dark there for a little bit, and then we lightened up, and then we kind of got
serious and
Well, we hit the three that you're not supposed to bring up on your first date, which
politics,
is what?
Religion.
Yeah, sports. Politics, religion, and sports.
I don't think we brought up politics, really. Mostly, I think we just hit. We hit religion.
Yeah, we
screwed it.
Well, all right. Well, thanks, Ryan. I appreciate you being on. We'll definitely, anytime that you want to come back on, you're welcome.
Oh, don't be careful there, man. When you give a mouse a cookie.
Right on.
All right, guys. Thank you.
I appreciate you being there, Carl. As always, thanks for coming to Doing Sports, since we don't like it and you do. And our listeners will dig it. And we will say goodbye to everybody. And we will, I guess, we'll reconvene this thing in another couple of weeks.
All right.
Adios, muchachos.
We will have to come up with a, there's going to be a trivia question we will have to put out. And I will actually put that on after the fact. We'll put it on Twitter and Facebook so that everybody can go on there and guess the trivia question. And if you answer the trivia question right, then you win a hat hand-knitted by yours truly. So as groovy as that sounds. Again, thanks, everybody, and we'll see you next time.
Okay, here's the trivia question. In last episode, which would be episode 11, we mentioned our trip to the roller derby. Now, in that trip, Carl, myself, and Jonathan took part in one of the halftime games, meaning for the audience, in which you take a roller skate wheel and roll it, throw it, whatever you need to do to get it into a hockey net on the opposite side of the floor. One of the three of us got it into the hockey net. The other two did not. You need to know which one of us got the roller skate wheel into the hockey net. Was it myself, Matt, was it Jonathan, or was it Carl? Send your answers to us. Go to our website, venterrobang.com. Go to the comment section, the contact page, and send it through there and send us your answers. Or you can tweet your answers to us. You can send them to us on Facebook. But get your answers to us either by email through our website, Facebook, or Twitter. And whenever we get those right answers, we will put all the right answers into a hat and have a drawing to win a hat by Matt. So that's the trivia question for this week. Go back, listen to the episode, get the answer, and submit it. Thanks.
Hey, Ventero Bangers, want to keep track of the Ventero Bang podcast crew? Well, how about just listening to our show?
Whoa, calm down, Matt. If they're hearing this, they're listening to our show, Matt.
Oh, yeah, I guess you're right.
Yeah, we just need to point them to our website, which is venterrobang.com. That's venterrobang.com, venterrobang.com.
Like Venterrobang Podcast, right?
That's pretty clever, yeah.
Okay. Tell them about winning a hat by Matt. Oh, wait, I just did.
Oh, yeah, you did.
You can there win you... a hat by Matt. We also have a money map where we map out where our money has been.
And an Ubuntu app, which I don't think anybody in the world has ever used, but hey, that's cool. We got it, you know? How many other podcasts can say that, you know?
Not very many.
Not very many.
For good reason.
Yeah.
You can also listen to us on iTunes or on YouTube. We also have Twitter and Facebook. Our Twitter handle, is it a handle?
Username, whatever you want to call it.
Username.
Yeah.
At Venterrobang. And it's spelled the same way as Venterrobang.com.
That's pretty clever.
Venterrobang. I can spell it too.
Cool. We also have a Facebook page, which is the same exact thing. You can go to www.facebook.com/Venterrobang podcast.
You can like us with a fox or in a box.
Okay.
Sorry.
I think they get the picture. There's other cool stuff there. There's actually a Skype and even our number. Why don't you tell them what our number is?
Our phone number is area code 707-412-8368, which is 707-I-1-2-VENT.
Clever.
Yeah, well,
very
we do
clever.
What we can.
We do.
Oh, we also have a Flickr page and a Pinterest page. We even have
MySpace.
A MySpace page, for God's sake.
Yeah. And you can email us. You can actually call us, which obviously you can by the number he just gave you.
And you can email us at contact@venterrobang.com. That's VENTERROBANG.
.com.
Right. Are we done?
No, I think we're done.
Okay.
All right.
I think we're done. Just find our webpage, and you can find everything else from there.
Go to our webpage, and don't worry about Twitter and Facebook and stuff, because you can find it at the bottom of every page and stuff. So, are we done?
And I'm sorry. I probably shouldn't have yelled at them.
No, definitely. We'll work on that.
Okay. Venterrobang Podcast signing off. Goodbye. The Venterrobang Podcast features the song She by Tenpenny Joke, available under a Creative Commons license on Jamendo.com.